Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Hacker Factory. I hope you all like my previous session. So today we'll start with the new topic, which is based on packet crafting and what are the attacks to be performed using packet crafting. So when we talk about the packet crafting, it's all about to bypass the filtration of any security device, right? And in this we can customize the packet as you want. So when we talk about the packets, there are a lot of packets transmitted in the network. Like there is a TCP packets, UDP packets, ICMP packets. So a lot of packets transmit in the network. And there are some following steps of the packet crafting, that is packet assembly. You guys can see on my screen that packet assembly is there, packet editing is there, packet replay is there, and packet decoding is there. So when we talk about packet assembly, it's all about the creation of packets. That first you are going to create the packets for the attack, like, right? So, and then we have the packet editing, in which you will perform the modifications, right? If you want to change the packets scenario, then you can perform modification in those created packets, right? And then we have the packet replay. It's all about the series of packet that has been captured, right? And the last, that is packet decoding, where you can analyze the network traffic, right, which is generated during your packet replay step, right? So these are the four steps that we have followed in the packet crafting. And again, the what kind of packets transmit in the network, when we talk about this thing, so there are a lot of packets. Like you can see on my screen, there are TCP packet, UDP packets, ICMP, IP, right, ARP packets. So a lot of packets that transmit in the network communication, and we capture these packets, we modify these packets for the attacks. So for example, any device, there, if there is any security on any device, will try to modify these packets and send to bypass that security device, right? And what are the attacks that can be performed using packet crafting? So there are a lot of attacks, right? We can perform DDoS attack, right? We can perform SMURF attack, LAND attack is there, SYN flood attack is there, right? ISN prediction attack is there. So in this, we can just perform TCP sequence prediction. So these are some of the attacks that I will cover in my next part of this session, that is totally about the practical, right? So I will discuss all about these attacks and perform practically. So these are some of the attacks. Let me just give some brief of these attacks. Like we have random source attack, right? So in this, what we'll do, we'll send the randomly source, randomly different sources to the destination address, right? Like there will be any kind of IP addresses, their domain names are there, right? And then we have the SMURF attack. In this, we will spoof the source address, right? And then we have a LAND attack. In this, the source and the destination address are same. Then we have SYN flood attack, in this, in which we will perform a multiple SYN request to the destination. So these are some of the attacks that will perform during our packet crafting. And the last, that is TCP sequence prediction. In this, again, we'll generate some sequence prediction to the target, and we'll wait for the response, that what kind of the predictions or the sequence numbers that we identify, right? So the main thing, what are the tools that we used for the packet crafting? So the most popular tools are, that is HPing 3 and Scapy. So these two tools are basically the most important that is used for packet crafting. And we can also perform packet crafting with nmap, but that is not fully for the packet crafting. So these two tools are basically fully for the packet crafting. So when we talk about the HPing 3, so this is the most powerful packet crafting tool. We can customize any packet in any form, right? So in, you know, for example, we have a TCP packet. So in TCP, there are multiple things, right? Like we have the source port is there, right? Destination port is there, TTL value is there, right? There are a lot of things that we can modify on the basis of attack, right? then we can bypass the firewall rules. So when we perform some kind of modification in the package, then we can try to bypass the firewall rules as well. Then we can also perform port scanning with the Spring 3 as well, right? You can also scan any port or multiple ports through the Spring 3, right? So this is the tool which is already in the Kali Linux. And again, we can also perform or exploit the TCP stack known vulnerabilities through Spring 3 attack, right? Sorry, Spring 3 tool. So let me give you some of the brief that what are the commands and the switches that has been used during Spring 3. So let's go to my Kali Linux, right? Enter my credentials. Open the terminal, right? And here you guys can just write Spring 3 and -l and hit enter. So you guys can see these are all switches that has been used in the Spring tool. So here you guys can see, right? For example, we have this is the TTL, right? This is the switch that is used for TTL. There is a ID switch, right? For the fragmentation, we can use this one, right? For more fragmentation, you can use this, or if you do not want to send the fragmentation, then you can use don't fragment flag. And there is a M that is MTU, that is maximum transmission unit is there, right? So there are a lot of switches that will help us to create the packets, and we can craft any packets for the attack, right? There you guys can see the screen. You can also take the dump of the packets in any form. The fax form is there, right? And these are some of the flags, that is SYN flag is there, reset is there, right? Push, ACK, urgent, XMIS, right? So you guys can use these flags to perform your attack, and on the basis of these flags, you guys can get the result. Like if you want to perform port scanning, then you can just write -SYN flag or -S and wait for the response. If there is any port open, then it will definitely, Spring 3 will definitely respond back with some kind of results, right? It may be the SYN ACK result, right? So this is about the Spring 3, and come back to that slide, that is the Spring 3, and you can also use man Spring 3. So you can see the manual of this particular Spring 3 tool. And the next, that is CAPI. So this one is also the most powerful tool used for the packet crafting, right? So in this tool, basically you can craft any value of the packet, right? There is a lot of things you can do with the SCAPI, and it's a Python interpreter, and you guys can do multiple attacks with SCAPI as well, right? And you can change or modify any header with SCAPI, right? So some of the commands that is used in SCAPI tool, if you just use ls function, then it display all the available protocols like TCP, UDP, DHCP. So it will tell you all the protocols, right? And we have LSC, display the SCAPI command functions, where you can see some of the command like send, receive, write. So I will show you these command as well. And then configuration is basically the conf command is show you the configuration of the SCAPI. And if you want to look for the help, you guys can just write help and function. Let me show you these things also. You guys have to just again go to the Kali Linux and write here SCAPI. This is also by default in your Kali Linux, and hit enter. And this is the SCAPI. We are in the SCAPI console, and here you guys can just write ls and function and hit enter. So this is the help of list of the commands that will used in the SCAPI framework or the protocols, right? So these are the protocols you guys can see as well. So there are a lot of protocols that will help you for the attacks as well. And there is also lsc, and here you guys can see some of the commands that is used with the SCAPI as well, like send piece and piece for the packet sniff. If you want to sniff the packets, that you can use for sniff, right? There is a flood, you can perform the flood attack also with the scappy as well, right? So TCP dump is there, so a lot of things you guys can do with the scappy as well. And if you guys want to see the configuration of this tool, then you can just write conf and you guys can see some of the configuration, right? And last we have also you have to just write conf, not the functions, and here you guys can see the configuration. And then the last we have the help and with the functions, and here you guys can see. And if you just write SR, and here you guys can see the help of the SR, right? So these are some of the commands that will help us to perform the packet crafting. And this is just the basic of these packet crafting tools. And in my next videos I will come up with the practical scenarios where we'll perform all the attacks, like how we can perform DDoS attack, how we can perform spoofing, right? So how we can perform land attack. So I will tell you all these things in my next part of packet crafting. So I hope you guys like my session, and if you like my session, please subscribe, share, and hit the bell icon.